Hello, good morning. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Mr. Santos Capelan Jr. Always wishing you a good day. Now, welcome back. This is my first tutorial in the month of May. I guess I was not very busy with my channel. But today, what I'm planning to do is to give you an idea or to give you bird's eye view, especially to those new engineers, mechanical engineers, regarding this chilled water system. Okay. Now, this chilled water system is composed of three major components. Okay. One, the first one is the chiller. Okay. Now, I have here one chiller. Okay. Now, this chiller has two screw type compressor. Okay. Now, actually, this system, I tried to recreate the system that I created in one of my previous projects, in Qatar, okay? Now, as I said, this system, chilled water system, is composed of three basic components. First is the chiller, okay? Now, my chiller is an air-cooled type chiller, okay? Now, as you can see, I have here my condenser. It's being cooled by condenser fans, okay? Now, this is my cooler, okay? Then I had two screw-type compressor, okay? Now, there are several types of compressor. Reciprocating, then this one is screw-type compressor, okay? There are other type of compressor. Now, here in the return line, okay? In the return line, I have here one butterfly valve, open and close butterfly valve, okay? Then I have a flow switch that will try to detect if there is flow in the evaporator, okay, or in the cooler. Now, if there is no flow, this chiller will try to shut down itself to prevent freezing of chilled water in the cooler, okay? Now, okay, so those are the basic components of this chiller system. The building management system will try to control the opening of the valve, okay? So meaning, if this chiller is in automatic position, as you can see here, I have here chiller one and of auto. If it is in automatic and there is no problem in the chiller or the chiller is healthy, system healthy status, I have here system healthy status, then the BMS will try to control this chiller based on the load requirement in the building, okay? Now, as you can see, my load here will be air handling units, and actually, this chilled water system is for warehouse, okay? Now, so the load will be one air handling unit that supplies the offices in the warehouse, then the it will try to supply also the fan coil units in other offices, okay? Now, the other components of the chilled water system is the primary pumps, okay? So we have here primary circuits, okay? Now, my primary circuit is composed of two chilled water pumps, and I can call it primary pumps, okay? Now, what are the points being monitored in primary pumps? Hand of auto, these are the basic monitoring points for a pump, like hand of auto, run, trip, okay? Then water flow, because we have a differential pressure switch across the pump, so we are also monitoring the flow. Then the control is the pump one enable and disable command, okay? Likewise, the other component in this chilled water system is the secondary pump, okay? Now the secondary pump, we have also some monitoring points there, like hand of auto, run and trip, the same for primary pumps now, but these secondary pumps are controlled by variable frequency drive, okay? Because based on the cooling load in the building or in the warehouse, this secondary pump will try to adjust the speed, okay, based on the chilled water requirement in the site, okay? Now, as you can see here in this chilled water piping, I have a bypass line. Okay. Now, this bypass line, actually, I have prepared already, or I tried to explain one chilled water riser diagram. Okay. But here, I'm going to explain to you how this simple chilled water system operates. And the second part of this tutorial is the simulation of the control. Because today, what I have completed is the graphics, okay? Now I have to bind the graphics to the physical points where I will get the real-time values, then prepare the simple logic control to be able to simulate the operation of this chilled water system, okay? So first component of this chilled water system is the chiller, chiller one, okay? This is an air-cooled chiller with two screw-type compressor, okay? Then one butterfly valve, open and close, that will be controlled by building management system and the start stop. Now this chiller, it has its own control, okay? Meaning it has its own microprocessor-based controller that will try to control the operation of this chiller, okay? So the next part is the primary pump, okay? Primary pumps, PP1, primary pump 1, and primary pump 2, okay? Now, as you know, primary pump 1 and primary pump 2 will be the one to pull back the chilled water from the building and push it back to the chiller, okay? Now, secondary pump will be the one to deliver or supply chilled water requirement in the building, okay? Now we have a bypass line. Now the purpose of the bypass line is to if there is no very less chilled water requirement in the building, then some of the water will just try to go back in the chiller, okay? Now so for the chiller, the points we have here is manual, then we have control, then run status, then trip. Okay, we will be able to monitor also if there's a trip in the chiller. Then primary circuit status, secondary circuit status. We will try to know if there is one or two pumps running. But actually, the sequence of operation, one primary pump will run and one secondary pump will run for the system, okay? There is no chance that both pumps will run for the primary and secondary pump because the design is duty and standby, okay? So primary duty and standby, secondary pump duty and there's a standby, okay? Now here, as a good engineering practice, we need to situate that there will be equal wear and tear in the equipment, okay? So we will be sequencing primary pump and secondary pumps. When I say sequence, we will try to write a control logic program that, let's say, when primary pumps, let's say primary pump one is running already 1 week, then it will stop, and at the same time, this primary pump two will take over. Okay, so it will sequence every week, or it will change over every week. Okay. Now, the problem here is to prevent water loss of flow in the chiller when we are changing over the primary pump. So what we can do here, what I can do here is start first pump two, then when it is running, then that's the time to stop the working pump, let's say primary pump one. So we will not lose chilled water flow in the chiller, okay? Now for the secondary pump, we don't have problem there because even sequencing is available there. Primary pump one will stop, then secondary pump one will run, okay? What to prevent is the loss of flow in the chiller, but it will be handled by primary pump, okay? So, guys, this is a simple chilled water system. that is composed of one chiller, two primary pumps, two secondary pumps. Now, the next part of this tutorial will be the simulation. I'm just showing you how I tried to prepare the BMS graphics. Okay, so what do you expect when you have this kind of project, especially to those new engineers or new BMS engineer? Okay, so these are the typical control and monitoring points for chiller, primary pumps, and secondary pump. Okay, so the next part of this tutorial will be my simulation of the control. Let me finish first the control logic program so that I can present it to you in the second part of this tutorial. Okay, so once again, I do hope I already give some information about chilled water system, a simple chilled water system. And again, if you are new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe. And you can always click the notification bell so that you will be notified if new tutorial video is available in my channel. And again, I'm saying God bless us all and bye for now.